Und damit ein herzliches Willkommen. Liebe Leute, es ist noch lange nicht das Finale, liebe Leute, noch lange nicht. Aber es wird schlimm. Und wie schlimm ist natürlich die Sache. Beim letzten Mal haben wir es geschafft und endlich Bibi, den Bad Boss, das Böse in Person, hier bezwungen. Doch, das war nicht der Anfang. Das war sicher nicht der Anfang, sondern es war mehr oder weniger das Vorspiel. Das Vorspiel, auf was nun erst kommt. Wir packen einfach King Proti einfach so rein. Ist wurscht. Liebe Leute, beim letzten Mal haben wir es geschafft und den Kern hier der Seraph gefunden. Und dort hat uns jemand besonders erwartet. Emir Alter. Wir haben ihn zwar bezwungen, doch das war immer noch nicht das Schlimme. Wir haben Mabel getroffen, die eigentlich von Emir Alter ermordet werden hätte sollen. Doch sie war noch am Leben. Und hinter ihr war noch etwas viel Schlimmeres. Ihr seht dieses Symbol. Dies ist das Symbol der Bestien. Die Bestien, die sich geschworen haben, die Menschheit auszulöschen. Die Bestie, sie ist eine Bestie, genau wie es auch nun schon Goetia, der König der Magier war, der die Menschheit ausgelöscht hat und der Ursprung der Grand Order war. Tiamat, das Monstrum, was wir in der siebten Singularität mit vereinter Kraft der Götter und dem Tod persönlich bezwingen konnten. Und natürlich Cat Pollock alias Fu, der ebenfalls seine Bestie herangewachsen hat. Beast 3, Session Chiara, die Bestie der Lust, ist nun erwacht, hier in Seraph. Sie ist die Priesterin, von der wir hier erfahren haben, die hier mit dem Dämonengott Zepha zusammengearbeitet hat. The third evil of humanity.
Yes, I'm dreadfully ashamed. But before I knew it well, I became as you see me now. A pathetic woman whose body was stolen by Zepha. One who had no other option but to fade away. Like everyone else on Seraphix, I was just another victim of Seraph. At least I should have been. It was at Zepha's womb that I became what I am. Became Seraph itself. Who would have thought?
So Seraph appears human because...
Yeah, that's right. The demon god Pillars Melish transformed Seraphix into my own body. It has been truly harrowing. For what feels like eternity, I have been attacked, broken and abandoned by countless Seraph spirits. It has gone beyond my wildest imaginings, a dream, a fantasy. The only question that remains is this. What price must I pay to continue feeling this exquisite ecstasy?
My head feels a little foggy.
Hold up, young man. Take what she says within a grain of salt.
Your name is Chiara, right? Wait, you the one who summoned BB while under Zepha's influence?
Yes. Zepha's power taught me about many worlds so different from our own. Peril world, is it? Yes, chronicle, theoretical phenomenon, and the like complex concept. This is how I came to know about another version of me, one among the countless number to exist. And in your world, distant in time and space, the moon itself was a holy grail called the Moonsel Automaton. In a deep dark space known as Far Side of the Moon, that version of me was able to claim the Grail. Among the immortal versions of me and numberless universe, she was the most unique. Zepha was very, very pleased with her, so much so that he linked us together. I who did nothing but suffer as Seraphix fell into a frenzy and into the other me, the one who acquired the moon cell for herself. As a result of this link, we became one and the same. So Zepha didn't salvage BB and digitize Seraph. No, he used you as a catalyst to give Seraph form. Correct. I tried to stop him, you understand. But my frail human body was no match for a demon god pillar. So you swallowed up my BB and me in the moon world. And you served as a basis for Seraph. No wonder Meld and I were salvaged from within you and their fashion into sentinels. It was wrong what I did to BB, what I did to all of you. You see, although Seraph managed to convert Seraphix into Seraph, he lacked the means to run it. And so I had no choice but to rely on help from you and BB, who had hacked Seraph on the far side of the moon. But that's all in the past now. You didn't succumb to Seraph perils, you survived the Holy Grail War. And now you're about to save the digitalized Seraphix. I believe it is time you were rewarded for your effort. I do so hope you will accept my deep as gratitude.
Wa. So basic, you victim too. Ja.
Aber sie ist eine Bestie! Sie ist der schlimmste Feind, den gibt's.
I'm not convinced. Stay back, Maxie. That sickly sweet scent of deception everything's about her lies. And even if she's telling, like, half-truths, there's something super important she's keeping on the L. Isn't that right, Session? Cool story, girl. But just one thing. Rest safe for now. You talked a lot about him before. You say that Seraph and your buddy are one and the same, so, like, how many servants have you munched on so far? Or, like, how many times have you exposed these masters to cruel dreams just to appease their appetite for a servant?
Please, please, don't judge me. I had no say in the matter. You really must understand. I was never taken in by the demon god's rhetoric, but the servant were just too delectable to pass up. It was all so hazy like a dream. So I never had any qualms about sucking every last drop from the master's corpses. So forgive me, but I lost count after the 17. Or, time or so.
Bibi never said a word about this. I knew someone evil was pulling our strings, but I had no idea it was a monster this horrible. Let me give you a hand, Maxie. I don't know about this beast thing you're talking about, but this woman cannot be allowed to exist in this world.
Oh, I wholeheartedly agree. That is why I've confirmed myself here all this time. But even that must soon come to an end. Have you enjoyed your little talk, Maxie? Are you finished here?
Please, stop Seraph.
And that is just the most delightful innocent proposal after all you've just heard. Oh, I can hardly wait. Ruining such a pure spirit with my own hands. Oh, it will be such fun.
Enough of this seductive crap. If I can handle every evil only, I can certainly handle your pale off self. Munchukin, down, Johnny. I skewer you with this heavenly rain. Right, I'm with you, Suzaka. Jin Aura, first to her arm. Everyone loses her sanity. This is their paradise for napping. All senses of time and strength is lost in the hours of twilight.
Das hört sich nicht sehr beeindruckend an.
Here goes! Napping in the dazzling sunshine and feasting! I got it!
Nicht mal in einer epischen Szene wirkt Tamus Cat eindrucksvoll. Okay! Sie ist besiegt.
No, it can't be. Did Seraph just hit the seafloor?
For what? It's penetrated it! Digitized Seraph, the scent cannot be stopped.
Then, that strange sound outside. Don't tell me we are
going to sink down with Seraph as it passes through the crust, upper mantle and lower mantle on its own way to Earth's core. Yes! And once it arrives there, Beast Tree will become Earth's brain and, its arrogant zone.
Was? Wait, what? I don't follow. Wieso?
I'm surprised, Pashlip. I did not think you capable of understanding such things. Everything up to this point has merely been foreplay. Once Seraph reaches Earthcore, I will become one with the planet. Or rather, this planet will become my body, and when it does, I will finally save humanity. I will bring an end to all the pain and suffering in the world. I will use 7 billion lives for the purpose of individual salvation. But before that... The time for talk is over. It is not. If so, I'm afraid your playtime must also come to an end. You see, you're already too late. I cannot allow bugs like you to stop me from reaching my climax now, can I? I'm so very sorry, but my paradise will be your final place of rest.
Don't underestimate us. Still, I'm confused. Maxie speaks true. Whatever you may be, your body, your spirit origin, is a little different from a servant's. The 5 servants that stand before you are warriors of unparalleled valor and skill. Not even a demon god could strike fear in their hearts.
Und Tamoket.
Session Kiara, this is your final chance to reconsider. Halt Seraph's descent and leave this world, lest you suffer a cruel, brutal defeat.
Oh, goodness me. I do so adore even your threats are considerate. But unfortunately for you, I'm afraid your soul is wasted. You're nothing more than insects crawling all over my body. What right do bugs have to tell me what to do? Mm-hmm. I've nothing to fear from the likes of you. I've had you in the palms of my hand all along. And if you're uncertain about what that might mean, well, allow me to enlighten you.
Kiara. Der wahre Feind, die Bestie in Person, das Monster, die Dämonen. Nonne, Sword of Death, taucht nun aus. Meine King Proteas Größe heißt du. Du hast keine Chance gegen uns. Wir werden obsiegen. Wir werden gewinnen. Okay, liebe Leute, vielleicht auch nicht. Komm schon! Sieht gut aus, liebe Leute. Aber mach schon mal mehr Schaden. Okay, liebe Leute, sieht immer noch gut aus. Es ist noch nicht verloren. Es ist immer noch nicht verloren. Okay, sie hat nicht mal einen Breakbar. Okay, liebe Leute, Mann. Es ist immer noch nicht verloren. Komm, wir machen jetzt einfach mal hier. Okay, gut, vielleicht. Okay, liebe Leute. Es ist, wie sie sagt, ein krasser Climax. Okay. Ich hab Guts. Ich hab Guts. Und sonst fällt mir leider nicht ein, Mann. Was haben wir denn sonst, Mann? Sie ist ein Monster, was seinesgleichen sucht, liebe Leute. Sie ist eine Bestie. Wir mussten einmal die komplette Sermon-Welt vereinen, um eine Chance gegen so ein Monster zu haben. Devilish Bodhisattva. Die Bestie. Leute, die habt ihr hinten. Also, okay, King Proteo verdeckt ist. Eigentlich habt ihr das Escape Upgrade gemacht. Nur damit wir es einmal machen können. Liebe Leute, ihr seht da im Hintergrund. Das ist die Mondzelle. Das ist der Ort. Der Mondzellenautomat, was die Kraft eines Heiligen Grales hat. Und scheinbar haben wir hier ein Monster gefunden, was noch mächtiger ist. Ich hab Guts, ich hab das überlebt. Leute, ein Monster, was seinesgleichen sucht. Selbst der Bad Boss ist nichts gegen dieses Wesen. Und die Musik ist krass. Selbst... Nein! Auf einen Hieb. How can this be? Auf einen Schwung.
I told you, didn't I? You've been in the palm of my hand all along.
Das ist übrigens krass, Mann. Also, liebe Leute, ich wusste leider schon. Aber trotzdem, wie sie einfach sagt, hier in der palm of my hand. Und nein, Leute, Mann. Sie verwandelt einfach. Sie ist einfach ein Monster. Und wirklich, im wahrsten Sinne des Wortes.
Goetia, King of Demon Gods, was it? He was a powerful beast, yes. But that all he was. Powerful. All he understood was destruction. I may still be weak as a beast. A mere chrysalis. But human mind is feeble and frail. No matter who or what all sapient beings hide lust in the heart, and so I told the soul in my hands. None with lust in their hearts can resist me. Now then, it's your turn, Maxi. So young, so ripe, so...
Not so fast. Now, Lip, press that load button. Did you press it? Oh nice! Beyond! A true hero! Here to save you in four in your half need with my Kuhai power! Nein! Here I come! Baby Shift! Was? Ihr habt gesehen übrigens, unsere Sunfish sind verschwunden, aber genau, Passion Lip ist nicht verschwunden!
Meld es auch nur irgendwo. Und hat uns jetzt erst auf ihr BB gerettet mit einem Raid Shift?
Okay. Wir befanden uns die ganze Zeit auf einer sexy nackten Kiara. Es gibt schlimmere Sachen. Es gibt schlimmere Tode, liebe Leute, Mann. Wir konnten der Lust leider nicht widerstehen, aber wir wurden gerettet. I gave up being on the 72 pillars. I became simply safer, a single demon god. I didn't know where the other three pillars went. Not that I care. I harbored no hatred for humanity. On the contrary, I had high hopes for its potential. I made managing humans as sources of information. My new life works. And I choose Seraphix as my base of operations. Übrigens, ich wollte noch sagen, Kiara ist natürlich auch die Person, die dann hier Gawain leider getötet hat. Flowers had previously reported that this facility was one of the causes of the unobservable region. Flaurus. Das ist Leaf Laner. I choose one of the Seraphix as my base of operation. Nein, da war schon. I choose one of the humans from the church to be my host. It was an emergency measure I had to take until I could heal from the wounds I suffered at the Temple of Time. My work would take several decades to complete. During that time, I came to the conclusion that a human host was the best way to avoid Chaldea's detection. I was so sure of it. The name of the human I possessed was Sessin Kiara. She was a therapist to lend people her ear and help to solve their problems. She was an absolute saint, worthy enough to be the vessel of a savior, even. She was persecuted because in her niche kindness was thought to be inconvenient in the human world. I can say this much, even now, if not for an outside influence like me, Kiara would be living a modest but happy life. She would have been respected among the members of a small community until the end of her days. She may have been kind, but that is all, not a quality I had need of, so I buried it in the depths of her subconsciousness. I acted while she was asleep and attempted to recover my strength over time.
Remarkable, quantifying emotions to soothe the hearts of those suffering from an old turmoil. What a brilliant idea, Sifa. You may use my body as you wish.
Kiara offered no resistance in handing her body over to me. I truly felt that her devotion, passion and respect for me were genuine. I, as a demon god, no less, felt good about the situation and used Kiara's intelligence and social standing to effectively controlling the Ulrich. Kiara's body proved to be an exceptional tool in my dealings with the opposite sex. No matter who they were, or what they did, none resisted the temptation it offered. Das ist verständlich, die Dämonen-Nonne der Lust. I learned much about human pleasure during that time. Of course, I truly would have been better off not knowing. Demon gods have no need for pleasure. For a spiritual being like myself, the pleasure of the flesh proved to be much, and I found myself increasingly unable to escape their allure. Human necessities and stimuli that came from relationships, even pleasures that incorporated spiritual. Before I knew it, I was begging Kiara to help me understand. Though completely obedient, it was Kiara who was controlling my actions before long. How might I best make her researchers capitulate or increase my authority even further? Her desire and ability to take action astonished me. The sheer ugliness within her was worthy of a demon god. Indeed, it was I who converted Seraphix into Seraph, but the changes that followed exceeded all exceptions. Kiara helped me and healed the Seraphix person that had been thrown into chaos. She engineered a situation in which she was absolutely indispensable. After that, she cut each of them off their group, one after the other. There was no rhyme or reason to whom was chosen. Engulfed by the crisis, overwhelmed by fear, twisted the personalities of the staff, made them depraved, stripped them of every last shred of humanity. Das ist genau das, was wir schon mal gehört haben. Das war in der ersten Aufzeichnung, wo wir gehört haben, dass sie, ich dachte ehrlich gesagt, Beckmann wäre natürlich hier der Anführer gewesen, aber Kiara war es. Kiara, die fromme Nonne, die Leute als Anführer aufgehetzt hat und dann dafür gesorgt hat, dass die Leute sich gegenseitig hier umbringen. One man killed his wife, fearing Kiara would abandon him. Another woman was killed by the others after she plotted to kill Kiara.
There was a woman who was killed simply because she saw Kiara looking sad. There was the one man who desperately wanted to escape Kiara's grave, but was unable to do so. I simply wanted to place to hide. I had no wish to see the world before me transformed into hell.
Haha, what are you saying, Sifa? The plan was always to have more and more fun, was it not?
It was then that Kiara seduced the person into opening up the planetarium to her. They opened Pandora's box of their own violation. BB and the 102 servants appeared on Seraph. Claiming she did it for my sake, Kiara took control and ruled Seraph from behind the scenes. By then, I had already lost control of her body. I could do nothing to stop her. It was now I who was possessed. Much as I had intended to possess her, she proved herself by superior in that regard.
I see, so each of the four escape pillars intended to create a singularity of their own.
Each of us had our own goals, and we all found that in order to achieve them, we needed to create singularities. When I told her that, her lips bent into a sympathetic smile of refusal. I could only ask why.
Why create a singularity when it would feel so much better to become one instead?
That was the moment I realized I had underestimated human desire, that it had gone beyond all control. But it was too late. I tried to separate myself from Kiara, but I had no influence over her whatsoever. I had not the slightest bit of freedom to speak of. I desperately wanted to leave. I begged to leave. To my shame, I only have done anything to be free. I even offered to find her a new victim in my place.
How could you say such a thing, Sifa? We share the same fate, the same ideals. Or perhaps you dissatisfied me with somehow?
I still remember the pang of terror I felt when she asked me that. Forgive me, please let me go. I am taking over each and every day. I'm helping to create a demon, and there's no stopping it, no turning back. I no longer had access to the diary I had hidden in the crypt.
Klar, das Tagebuch stammt nicht von einer Person, die sich gerettet hat. Es stammt natürlich nicht von der Person, die vom Dämonengott bemannt worden ist. Es war der Dämonengott.
All that I was permitted. The only place I granted was in the tip of Kiara's pinky finger. Shaking off the fear, I continued to beg and plead. Free me. Let me go.
Nonsense, Sifaya. You please upset me. You were mistaken to think that my pinky finger was yours to reside in. That it was the only place for you. There's no place for you inside me anymore. I gave you that only was a curtsy. All that remains of you is your consciousness, and that only because I allowed.
I lost my mind. As madness overtook me, one last thought came to me. This womb stole everything I had ever been. What little is left of me would fade away if I were to leave her. What is worse, to be enslaved by a human, or to die proudly as a demon god? It was a difficult decision, but in the end I chose the former.
We are like friends, you and I.
She beamed as her smile, dripping with love, disgusted even me.
But if that's truly what you decide, I guess I have no choice but to let you go.
No, don't. No, no, no. Stop. Your pinky is more than enough for me. Please, don't abandon me. My goals are my will and my reason for being. Please, don't take them away from me.
You'll be fine, Sifa, as long as we have our pleasure. You'll be fine. Your goal is humanity's salvation. Apparently so is mine. So leave everything to me and return to the place from which you came.
Ah, I'm disappearing, disappearing, fading fast. I can't hold on, can't hold on. How did it come to this? I did nothing wrong. Why? No, I don't want this. This is horrible. It's too much. Don't kill me. Don't abandon me. Don't throw me away. Don't forsake me, Kiara.
You've been sadistic, Kiara. You purposely chose to do the opposite of what Sifa told you to do, didn't you? You don't listen very well, do you? I'll never do it that Sifa asked of me. But whatever you said after that has nothing to do with me as long as since been forgotten. I see. Well, Sifa isn't blameless, I guess. He consumed a large number of Seraphic's personnel too. We can just file that under karma and move on. So it's my job to run the Holy Grail War, isn't it? So, if so, I'm going to do it objectively as possible. Yes, of course. It should take at least a year in Seraph terms for Seraph to emerge, yes? And we need something to keep us busy while we are failing, right? If so, the best way I can think of amuse myself is to summon more servants. Ah, oh, it's such a wonderful and exciting prospect that I can hardly contain myself. I can experience the lights I've only dreamed of before now. And this is all thanks to Sif. Was it? Ah, whatever it was. If nothing else, I thank the Demon God Pillar for this opportunity.
Was waren dann eigentlich die Wesen, die wir bekämpft haben? Gute Frage, liebe Leute. Aber so wie es aussieht, gibt es eine Person, die uns hier in der Stunde der Not zur Hilfe geeilt ist und uns helfen kann. So hat es angefangen, liebe Leute. Dort hat der erste Garalkrieg in der Mondzelle angefangen, in einem ganz normalen Schulraum. And suddenly an all-time school.
I thought I was dead. War auch unsere Sounds schon gerettet. We are all dead, like literally dead. What the hell's going on?
I could not be happier. Survival is a victory all its own.
Phew! I was worried we'd brought it out of farm. Some people just can't help messing up. But thanks, BB. Seems you can be useful at times, huh?
Of course I can. Though maybe I would have been better off saving everyone but you. But never mind that. BB, you're with us super duper safe. How did I do, Senpai? Did I make you proud?
Eher verwundert.
Now you just have to admit that I'm cute. I'm reclaiming the mantle of hero in it that melts down for me. Think again, BB. Maxi won't forget all of your meddling with that easily.
Meltis! Und Lip wahrscheinlich auch! Ach! Aber wie?
I'm just glad you're safe, Maxi. I always believed you could do it, but for a second there I was kinda worried. Jeez! You're only paying attention to the egos. What a cute girl I gotta do to get a thank you.
I have no idea what just happened. Das ist eigentlich das.
Oh, I guess that makes sense. I mean, the plot's sweared pretty hard back there. We're running short on time, so let me explain. That true demon, or rather that evil of humanity in this reality, got the beast of you. Best of you. Session Kiara, the depraved nun, the boss of Seraph, where we nearly ended you. Well, your servant actually did die, technically. All of them, in fact. You should really try a bit harder next time. So, I maybe rewound this time just a teeny bitty so you could have a do-over.
Nur so als blöde Frage auch gewesen.
Ha! You've got to be kidding, BB. That level tough time reversal is kinda scary, don't you think? Ha hey, I know, right? I bet you think twice about messing with me and Seraph again. Time travel in the digital world is actually pretty simple. So long as it is time leap within a quantum locked period. Well, a leap of up 3 hours, give or take. You need the right coordinates in space though. Especially this classroom is outside of Seraph, about 100 meters or so above it. Seraph digitized the Mariana Trench as a pass through it, you see. Under these special circumstances, the higher you go, the farther back you go in time. I see. Like using time as a ruler, and because we are 100 meters above Seraph right now, that means that we've traveled back to about 90 seconds before your death, roughly speaking.
Audis. So we may venture up from Seraph. Pardon me if I'm slow to grasp, but does that mean that if we leave Seraph and return to the surface, we could go back to time by 2.5 for real world hours? Which is to say, back before this all began? Before Chaldea's master arrived?
Theoretically, yes. As long as you get the coordinates right. Problem is, once you're in Seraph, escaping Kiara's sexual allure, kinda like a gravitational field really, is no easy task. For one, you would need to exceed the speed of light. I mean, that's definitely possible in the digital world, but the spiritrons that compose spirit origin
wouldn't be able to survive in the stress of the speed. Liebe Leute, wir machen jetzt hier mal einen Break. BubbleNet, erzähl, wieso du mich gerettet hast. Koa, Senpai, Sensei, was auch immer.
Caring to those speeds who would make a short work of even an Iron Servant. So even if you did try to escape Seraph, you'd probably burn up in the process. At least that's what would normally happen. See, I told you it's impossible to escape from Seraph. But Seraph cannot be left on its own on devices, you know that, right? It would result in the vile evil of humanity, Beast 3, becoming one off with the Earth. Not even I can laugh that one off. Don't forget, it was the reason I was dispatched to Seraph in the first place.
So you're not Kara's minion?
Not at all! Well, not anymore. I was simply bound to do her bindings, forced to serve as the manager of Seraph. But now the Holy Grail was handed. I've been set free.
Habe ich eigentlich den Heiligen Gral bekommen?
And now you can... You know what that means. Now Bibi can serve as your commander.
Right, we get it.
You don't need to talk your ears off. So, Commander, the plan is to defeat the Lady and destroy Seraph? A fine plan it is. We certainly all know what a piece of work she is.
Just one problem. We don't stand a chance. If we had 100 servants, she'd still flatten us.
What is Beast 3 anyway? Seems like the sort of thing only in the 21st century could produce, you know?
Given how unmature they usually are, it's kind of annoying yet you're more the one asking a pertinent question. In fact, you're getting kind of plushy, very plushy. I'm tempted to turn you over to Kara right now.
I'm being serious here, you know?
We are on where you know. Anyway, the Beast 3 you have met is probably Air, one half of Beast 3.
Air as in right side or something?
Yes, it's also short for Rapture. I just came up with that right now. I did some digging, you found that some beasts came in pairs. Left and right, yin and yang. In that sense, Kara is heir of beasts free. Or rather, that is what she's becoming. You could say she's like a butterfly about to emerge from its chrysalis.
So she's still just a chrysalis, you say? Do you mean to say she will grow even stronger as time passes?
I wonder. When I say a butterfly yet to emerge, what I mostly mean is that she will be free to move, versus being unable to move at all. Kara is served to become a beast, but she also is still bound to Seraph. So what I mean by a butterfly emerging to this case is that she plant will fuse together on Seraph reaches the Earth's core.
Oh, I've got like a super bad feeling about this. Let's finish her already. Pests gotta be get squished, right?
Now don't get hasty. Let's not get ahead of ourselves. I think Bibi is about to tell us how to deal with her. Yes, right now, defeating Kara Beast 3 will be no easy task, but I maybe kinda saw this coming, so ta-da! Special Bibi action for just this occasion. The absolute dirtiest exploits in the history of ever. I've got an anti-libidus serum that suppresses Logos Eater as skill that leads to death by self-gratification in any sapient being. I've got ways to counter-attack the beast's allure. I've got ways to level it down. I've got ways to seal its skill. Senpai, I've got what you need, and I prepared it all special for you. And it's all reasonable priced.
You're selling them? Did you miss the part where the whole world is in danger? She's just like... Das gefällt mir, she's just like you, Stefan.
So gut, man.
Oh, come on, Senpai. What did you expect? Do you think stuff this awesome just grows on trees? Why do you think that I've been collecting a sacrament for so long? It wasn't exactly easy to help you without Kara catching on. Everything I did was to prepare for this. And that's why I set aside my feelings and skimmed a little off the top.
What's KP?
Oh, that's a secret. A trade secret, in fact, really. And anyway, all the conditions have been met. BB, proud early of humanity mode unlocked.
Beast 3 is the enemy.
And this unpredictable disaster cannot be averted without your help. I'm not an inhabitant of this world. I'm just an AI dispatched from the Moon Cell Automation. But, as a good ally of humanity and a temporary manager of Seraph, I request your help. Operation CCC, Cast Cupid Cleanser, is a go! Let's throw some cold water on this evil of humanity that's trying to put it on the planet.
Pipi hilft uns. Only an hour till we set off for battle.
There are you. I've been looking for you. What are you doing all alone in the classroom like this? Something about the courtyard that caught your eye? Wait, does the school remind you of yours? Let Bibi and I have some sort of attachment to this school. That doesn't mean we were students, though.
Sakura-Schule, natürlich.
That's right. I forgot to tell you, but I'm almost back on my feet. Take me with you when you leave to fight Session. If I see respond to big with her. You're suspiciously quiet. Is there something you want to say to me?
Thank you for everything.
Pfft. What is this about? It's fine. Don't worry about it. It's all about give and take. After all, isn't it? We've been fighting together ever since you arrived on Seraph. You were a weak master then, and you are not much better now. I've seen my fair share of adversity, of sadness, but really, that's not much a bad thing. So honestly, I feel like I should be on the thanking you. I already got what I wanted most in this world. If there's anything I could say in thanks, I would. As Seraph ceases to exist, Lip and I return to our world, and our bond with you will be severed. But I'll stay by your side until it happens. You're my one and only master.
Listen, you're not hiding anything, are you?
Absolutely nothing. The past in the past, Maxi. Farewell, master. If you escape Seraph, give my regards to Bibi for me.
Melt stuffer has been added to the KP shop. Es ist wirklich mit Abstand das Beste, was wir jemals hier hatten. Also, liebe Leute, eine Aufgabe wartet uns auf uns nur noch. Das Monster, die Bestie zu besiegen. Session Kiara. Und wir könnten uns an dieser Stelle schon mal Kiaras Punisher kaufen, das heißt, sie nimmt nicht ihre Double-Spur, das hat also ihre riesige, unbesiegbare Vormann. Und nun geht es natürlich noch darum, ich will mir natürlich noch den ganzen anderen Schmarrn hier kaufen, weil ich es einfach kann, liebe Leute. Und nun verhindern wir, dass sie ihre Bodhisattva-Form annimmt. So sieht es nämlich aus. Bibi, die Beschützerin der Menschheit. Wer hätte es gedacht, liebe Leute? Okay, liebe Leute. Ein Fight wartet noch auf uns und diesen werden wir hoffentlich schaffen. Beim nächsten Mal geht es dann zum Grande Finale des Seraph Events. Bis dahin, haut rein und auf Wiedersehen. Ciao.